So here's where we're at. Everyone is just two ribbons away from having the complete complement of 3 through 6. See, on this line, there's 4 different contest ribbons. Which means there's only 1 contest left for each of them to do. That gets the last contest ribbon and contest star. Of course, they have all the rest of the ribbons, too. The extra one for purified. Now, since this is Omega Ruby, we could use the Pokeblock mechanics here and max everything out without regard for Sheen. But we don't need to. These are the stats they've had ever since Sapphire. You can see Beauty only about halfway full. But it's enough. Let's go. So first up, we'll knock out the cool contest. That'll be Vampinos. Up against Lisia and Ali. Yoko and Galaxy. Jeff and Lauda. Turn 1 order is determined by the visual score, so it'll be Vampinos first, then Ali, then Galaxy, then Loudoff. Might as well start simple, Aerial Ace for 7. I don't think Ali has anything more compelling to do here than Dragon Dance, which is only worth 2 hearts. Let's get a star for future turns. For now, I'll have a 5 heart lead. And the way these scores work, Vampinos leads Ali in the visual round by 0.8 hearts, so I need to be tied or better through the talent round. Well, 5 heart cushion for now is pretty good. Galaxy also uses Dragon Dance. Howl? Yup. Loudoff uses Howl, ties me with 7. Now it's a tie for who goes first next turn, and a tie for who goes third. How is that tie gonna be broken? So I go first again, which means I have an easy jackpot. Question is, do I want to take it with Steel Wing or Hyper Beam? Obviously, the big drawback to picking Hyper Beam is I can't use it again on turn 3. I can't do anything on turn 3, and I score 0 hearts there. The drawback to picking Steel Wing is that Steel Wing would be stale on turn 3 if I have some reason to use it there. But I don't think anyone can displace me out of first place on turn 3, so I'll just take the 9. Ali only gets 8 with Outrage. Unless Galaxy decides to go for Hyper Beam this turn. It'd be odd, but not unheard of. I'll just go for echoed voice. I'll retaliate. That's not gonna earn anything. Let's get the one heart for a cool, tight match. Galaxy uses Hyper Beam. Okay, so I only get 5. And Ollie will take 8. It's a loss of 3 hearts on this turn. I'm still up by 2. But with Galaxy sitting out, if I pick Aerial Ace, I get 8. If I pick Hyper Beam, I get 10, and Ollie drops to 4. In exchange for an uncontested turn next turn. I think I'll play Hyper Beam. Aerial Ace, of course, get your 8. Raise the voltage to 4 because you can't help but pick a cool move. And I've got Hyper Beam. Four. So my lead is up to 8. And that buffer should be enough to survive whatever you do with the free turn. Loudup can either go for Hyper Voice, which jams us both equally, or Howl. Yep, it's Howl. Don't really care. Ollie's going 3rd this turn. Probably Tailwind, I would expect. Yup. Well, I had a buffer of 8. This is worth 5. So I'm up 3 going into the last turn. And I will probably be moving 4th. Thrash, get your 6. Get your 7, you have a star. We have Ollie is using Aerial Ace. Galaxy is using Hyper Beam. Hyper Beam will earn the jackpot. Don't really care about that. Question is, what is Loudoff gonna do? I I think you go for Hyper Voice, which is good because that'll knock down Ollie down a couple more. 8. Ollie would be earning 2 hearts. What else could you pick? No matter what you pick, it'll be worth exactly 3 hearts this turn. Unless for some reason Galaxy decides not to go for Hyper Beam and lets Loudoff take the jackpot? Huh. He probably isn't getting much done. Steel Wing would probably do 1 heart better than Aerial Ace, but if that Galaxy playing odd move choices go pay off, Aerial Ace is the safe choice. It's thrash. Yep, it's Hyper Beam, so Galaxy takes the jackpot. That is perfectly fine. Ollie gets knocked down to 4. I get 3. Now, even if this isn't Hyper Voice, I have enough of a buffer. Hyper Voice. Ollie goes down to 2. And I actually gain a heart on this final turn. And win. Contest star. Of course, those ribbons aren't the only prizes for completing contests. You get free stuff! Comet Shard! Money, money, money! A second Comet Shard! Okay, 1 down, 4 to go. Okay, now it's Charithmia's turn. Almost in melodic. Layla and Gorflare. Lisia and Ali. And of course, Cat and Charithmia. This contest, they start with a cushion of 2.8 hearts over Ali, so I can afford to lose by up to 2 hearts in the talent round. Now, Ali could take Dazzling Gleam for 5, could take Round with the expectation of getting 7. I hope it's Round because I'm going to play Roar here. And sure enough, it's Round. We both get 3. My logic plays Aqua Ring. So that affects all of us. I'm still going 4th. Here, I think Ali plays Dazzling Gleam. Gorflare could play Whirlpool here. That would be the one way to stop Ali from hitting the jackpot. I think Dazzling Gleam is the play. Either Round or Aqua Tail. If it's Blizzard, that would be nice too. I'm playing Hail. If Gorflare does not pick Whirlpool, then... And if Gorflare picks Aqua Tail, takes the easy 5 points, then Ali gets the jackpot. That would be 13. I can at least knock it down to 7 by picking Hail. 7 to 3 is a deficit of 4. 13 to 7 if I pick Mirror Coat would be a deficit of 6 on the turn. Yep, it's Hail. Whirlpool! Ooh. Now, who's going first next turn? Probably Milotic, because Aqua Tail with the star, that's 5 instead of 4. Round even better, 7 instead of 4. What is my Lotic doing first? Probably Aqua Ring. This turn ends up being a tie. Icy Wind is a combo. That'll get me 8. Ollie could play either Round or Draco Meteor and get 7. That'll give me a 1-heart lead. Melodic takes the jackpot, that's fine. Melodic starts out 6.2 hearts behind Charisma, so I can afford to lose to Melodic by a bigger margin. Gorfler want to play Agility here, or just Surf again and jam us all equally. Ooh, Draco Meteor, then Surf wouldn't jam us all equally. Aqua Tail, get your 5. And then I'll be in second next turn. And since Milotic can't help but use beauty moves, unless you want to pick a duplicate Aqua Tail, that means point number 5 goes to me. Either way, it's worth 8. Hail keeps the combo intact. Aqua Ring, get another star, sure. And Charisma finishes it off with Hail. Sterling obviously irrelevant here. And Serene Bless Rain. Oh, we got Round, yep. To 7. What does Gorfler want? Yep, Surf. Now it's the Surf. So it's 6-5. Still a 1-heart lead. Take Icy Wind for 8 again. Ollie probably plays Dazzling Gleam to get 5. Could play Draco Meteor to get 7, but either way. Icy Wind and I just win. Thank you. Warflare probably takes this with Aqua Tail. Yep, and that'll be number 5, but you're way too far behind. And Logic is probably going to go for Blizzard, which jams everyone the same. Yep, Blizzard, so Milotic gets 4, Charizmia to 5, Ollie to 2, Gorflare to 7. Pretty close between Wallace and Lisia. A pretty big margin at the top. Get some screenshots. And get some goodies. That's no Comet Shard. Next up, I've got Elvira. Alien Glovelin. And there's Lisia and Ollie. Of course, the reason you've been seeing these discontinuities in the video, I've been intentionally resetting to get Lisia and Ollie in every contest. What better way to send off Gen 6 ribbons than by facing the hardest opponent we can every time? And the thing about cute contests, Ollie can get 7 hearts with Disarming Voice by going first, or 7 hearts with Growl by going fourth. But in second or third, there's just not much in the way of good options. So my goal is to try and keep Ollie out of those extremes. I'm going to play double team, knowing I get 0 points for it. Ollie has Home Claws, but that's worth 2, even though it gets a star all the same. wish. That's 4 points. Love Run plays Draining Kiss? Yep. That's 5. Now, what if Loveland plays a Sweet Kiss, probably? Princess is going for Play Nice this turn, which should earn the jackpot, unless it's unnerved. The way unnerving works, it's always a 60% chance divided by however many Pokemon are left to take it. So with 3 taking it, each one has a 20% chance. If you have a pending combo, like both Princess and Ollie do, you can tell by the rainbow-colored flashing background, the chance increases by 10%. If you have a star, like Ollie and Elvira do, each star reduces the chance by 10%. So, Sweet Kiss should be 30% chance for Princess, 20 for Ollie, 10 for Elvira. That'll also be applause meter number 4. Depending on who gets unnerved. Should I play Covet here? If Princess gets unnerved, Ollie takes a jackpot and I copy that. Sweet Kiss. Princess gets unnerved. Ollie can't help but play a cute move. Disarming voice. That's worth 12. Now Covet will be worth 15. Now that I've successfully kept Ollie out of position 1, I just play Double Team again. This time I do keep 1 heart from it because of the first star. Get a second star. Attract, chance to unnerve, 30% each. Draining Kiss. 5. And what does Princess do? Confuse Ray. Okay. And Ali is again stuck in second. Sweet kiss. Princess might go for Zen Headbutt here. If everyone plays a cute move, then Princess gets the jackpot. If one of them plays a non-cute move or gets unnerved, then Elvira's in line to take it. Covet would cover either of those bases, barring a multiple unnerve. Okay. Pwn Claws get a second star. You get three. And what does Princess do? If it's Zen Headbutt, it's Wish, so you get the jackpot, and then Elvira copies it for the second time. Now Covet for 13. So I've gained 10 hearts on Ali this turn alone. And Ali once again gets stuck in third position on the tiebreaker. Let's just play Baton Pass here, get my 9. Oh, it's only 8. The Baton Pass works as stars count triple. No more than that. So it's 7 plus 1. Then Headbutt for 4. Chance, nope. Draining Kiss copies all of our scores at half power. It's worth 10, but that's not nearly enough. Here's the 11th. And the applause meter ends at 4. And that is how you prevent Ali from ever getting anything going. What do we have here? Berries. More berries. Something other than a berry? I guess that's three down. That leaves Hypnobro. Ruslan and Lisia. And the anagram of Lisia. There's Ali once again. Elijah and Shargob. Hypnobro. You go for power swap, oh well. But I think you play Dream Eater here. Play Miracle Eye, get my 7. Unfortunately, that's the only move Hypnobro gets that has that effect, and it comes with a combo flag. We can't really take advantage of, because the second half of the combo would have to be Fissure, Horn Drill, Guillotine, or Sheer Cold. Obviously doesn't get any of those moves. And Ali goes for Dream Eater. And we're tied at 7. Assurance. That's going to be 5. I think Lisia starts with Calm Mind. Could be Psych Up. And then we have a trick. So who's going to get the random turn order first position? That player gets to take the jackpot. And it is Shargob. The Shargob could go for Scald. Ooh. Ali could go for Sing. think natural gift is the play from this position, even though the jackpot will probably already be gone, and then it'll be back to zero applause. If it's sing, then I don't really want to pick future sight. Gold natural gift, I could copy it with roleplay. Do I want to go for that? Which do you go for, natural gift or sing? Huh. Lisia probably has calm mind here, doesn't really matter. I'll take magic room. Poison fang, so you get it. I guess Ali goes for sing. Oh, natural gift, oh, that's only gonna get one heart, plus another one for the match. So after this, I have a lead of two. Picking calm. Psych up, so Lisia is going second next turn. What does Shargob pick? This has to be Scald. You could either use Trick Room or Calm Mind. That would pump the applause meter to 3. And I don't want to pump it to 4. So I will pick Roleplay. That's the only move I can pick. Scald, okay. And I get unnerved. Doesn't really matter because roleplay wasn't for the hearts. Oh, it ignores my skipped turn. It's not a combo. So that's 7-0 for Ali. Shh. Jargob takes the jackpot again with Poison Fang. Ollie uses Natural Gift. Leah with Psych up, I think. And I'll play Future Sight because I know Leah has nothing but clever moves. That'll get you 10. Once again, you get stuck with 2. Psych up for 7. Future Sight for 7. And that's going to make it a tie between Leah and Hypnobro for who goes second next turn. With a plus 3. Jargob is probably going to pick Scald again in position 1. So whoever moves third next turn... Ooh. Blah. But I can at least play Magic Room and prevent anybody from taking the jackpot. And Ollie gets unnerved, I'll take it. Stored power with no stars, that's not gonna do a whole lot. Ollie even comes in third because of those 2 jackpots from Jargob. The last contest left is with Nonstick. Mm-hmm. going galaxy. And one more opportunity to beat Lisia and Ollie. Clayton Heracles. At nonstick. Tough contest. There's a lot of jamming going on. So hopefully you want to get into fourth position and be immune to jams. Double team for 1 point. I think Ollie's turn one has to be Earthquake. I get jammed down to zero. With a dragon dance, okay. Reversal for 6. Heracles plays Endure here, I'm sure of that. What would Ollie do? Aerial Ace, you're not moving first with that. Could play Giga Impact. Probably don't want to play Takedown this early. Especially if Galaxy has a Crunch waiting after it. Galaxy could play Thrash, that seems more likely than Ollie going for Takedown. But anyway, I've got Wild Charge, which is drawback 3. There's Endure. Giga Impact, so you're going ahead and skipping turn 3. Crunch. So 3 for Galaxy. Ollie drops down to 1. And meanwhile, I pick up the jackpot for 13. I could play Iron. Ollie isn't doing anything. Galaxy has a Stale Crunch. I would expect Dragon Dance here. Heracles obviously using Reversal. That'll be worth 9. I'll just pick up another star with double team. Even if Galaxy goes for Hyper Beam, I end up at negative 2. Thrash, that's fine. I'm giving serious thought to explosion now on turn 4. Because the one thing I don't want is to get caught up in a Hyper Beam and Giga Impact War and get jammed to oblivion. Now, if you skip a turn with Hyper Beam or Giga Impact, you can still get jammed on the skip turn. But if you skip the rest of your turns with explosion and there is still one turn or more left to be skipped that way, then you cannot get jammed on that turn. Although, if this is a problem. Wild Charge Iron Defense is probably just better than that. Or even using a dupe double team. What does Ollie want to do this turn? Oh, takedown, obviously. So I expect another Endure. Could be Dragon Dance, or it could be Crunch. I'm gonna play a duplicate double team. Don't want to give Ally any chance of getting the jackpot. Crunch, there it is. And Ollie gets... Oh, Earthquake, okay. That works even better for me. Although Ollie does get to go first and pick up the fifth point. This is Giga Impact. Giga Impact is worth 13. Hyper Beam will drag it down to 9. Does Heracles want to use Reversal or Giga Impact? If I use Wild Charge, that's 10. After a Giga Impact, I only get 2. Or it can just Iron Defense lock in a 4. Explosion. Get 10 or... I'll play Explosion. Even if Heracles uses Giga Impact, I still get 6 off that. Ollie gets the bonus, that's fine. I have enough of a lead that you can tap at. Well, I actually come out ahead this turn, no matter what Heracles does. Giga Impact, yep, so Ollie gets 5, Nonstick gets 6. On top of that turn that went 13-1, that's an easy win. That's all of them. Everyone has their ribbons. Let's find out what final pieces of loot I get. That there's just one other thing left to do. Hey, Charithmia. Are you ready to get your last ribbons in 6? Let's see. Right there. That. This one goes here. That's 79. And the contest star can go right here. And that's number 80. Look at you.